Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another tutorial. And in this tutorial, we are going to create this awesome folded image effect using only HTML and CSS. As always, I had explained every single step, so make sure you don't skip any part of this tutorial. Also, I regularly upload awesome tutorials related to web development, so make sure you are subscribed to this channel. And by the way, guys, this YouTube channel is in collaboration with an amazing platform known as Newton School. You can check out their website. The link is in description. And also, let's understand a bit about what exactly is Newton School. Let's see about what is Newton School. So Newton School is a platform which prepares you for your career in tech. It has courses designed for working professionals, freshers, and even people with no tech background. That means even if you are from a non-tech background, you can also join this platform and can make your career in tech. Newton School will first train you for 6 months and will help you become an amazing full stack developer. Now you might be thinking whether this platform is free or not. So let me tell you a cool thing, that you don't have to pay Newton School anything until and unless you are pledged with a minimum 5 lakh CTC. I repeat, guys, you don't have to pay Newton School anything for the 6 months full stack developer training until and unless you are pledged with a minimum 5 lakh CTC. And I think this is something that all of us should expect from any training program. So must check out their website for more information. I will provide the link in description. Now on their website, you can see they have something called the Launchpad. So Launchpad is basically an initiative taken by Newton School for people who want to start their coding journey from scratch, and that too absolutely free of cost. This video of mine will be also available on the Launchpad section. You can go there anytime and you can learn basics of programming languages, you can practice quizzes, and even you can do assignments. These all things are completely free to do. Now let's start creating our folded image effect. So I had opened the output here. Now let's create the HTML part for this effect. Okay, so first of all, I will create a container and I will use div tag for that, and I will give it a class of container. And inside this container, I will include 4 elements. So basically the number of folds you are seeing here is those elements basically. Okay, so we will create 4 elements for 4 number of folds. Okay, so let me create the 4 elements. So I will use span tag for each of the folds, and we want 4 folds. Okay, so I will create 4 elements. Okay, so we got the 4 elements for creating the folds. And now we have completed our markup. Now let's start writing CSS for that folded image effect. Okay, first of all, I will target my container and I will give it a fixed width and height. So I will give it a width of 500 pixel and a height of 300 pixel. And also let's give it a border so that we can see it properly. So I will give it a border of 3 pixel, solid and black in color. So you can see we got our container. Now let's center it within our body tag. Okay, so I will write body. I will remove the default margin given by the browser. So I will reset the margin to 0. And now I will use the flex method to center our container within body. So first of all, I will give height of 100 VH to our body. And now I will use the flex method to center our container within body. So I will write display flex and justify content center to align our container horizontally center, and align items center to align our container vertically center. So you can see we got our container in the center. Now let's style these span elements. Okay, so I will target all these spans inside container, and I want all of them to cover equal space. So we have 4 elements here, so I will give width of 25% to each of them, and I will give them a height of 100%, and also I will give them a border of 2 pixel solid red in color so that we can see them properly. But I had already told you in my previous videos that width and height doesn't get applied to inline elements. Okay, so span is an inline element, so width and height will not get applied to span. Okay, so you can see width and height is not getting applied to our span elements. So what we will have to do is we will have to convert span element either into inline block element or block element. Okay, so we will convert it to inline block by using display property. And now you can see width and height is getting applied to our span elements. Now I also want to give my container display flags so that our span are in one row. And now you can see we got our span in one row and they are fitting the container. Okay. And now what I will do is basically I will give the same background image to all of my span and I will change the background position of that background image so that our four elements will look like they are containing a single image. Okay. So let's create that and then you will understand better. So I will target each of my span elements. So first of all, I will target the first span element. So I will use first child pseudo class to select the first span child of our container. And before giving background position to our first span child, let's give background image to all of our span elements. Okay, so I do have the background image link. So let me copy and paste it. So I had included the background image in all of our span elements so that you can see. Also, I want their background size to be cover so the background image will fit its container. Okay, so we have given background size cover. Now we have to give them a background position. Okay, so let me first target all the span childs. So for the second child, I will use nth child selector. So I will write nth child and I will pass 2 to it. So this selector will basically select the second span child of container. Okay. So now let's similarly select the third child. And you can see the fourth child is also the last child. So for selecting the fourth child, I will use last child pseudo class. Okay. So we have selected our each of the span elements. Now we have to give them background position so that they combinedly look like a single image instead of four different images. Okay. So first of all, I will start with background position 0. Okay. So understand this point. Okay. So let's see how to give them background position so that they combinedly look like a single image. So the very first element is starting from 0. So we have given background position of 0. Okay. Now our second element is starting from 25% of width of our container. Okay. So see this basically. We have given 25% width to each of our span elements. So this is our first element and this is of 25% width of our container. And right after it, our second element is starting. So it is starting after 25% of width of our container. So the background position of our second element will be 25% of width of our container. So 25% of width of our container will be, our width of container is 500 pixel. So its 25% will be, you can see here, it will be 125. Okay. So the background position will be 125 pixel, but you have to give it in negative direction. Okay. Now you can see we have successfully given the background position of our second element. Now we have to give background position of our third element. So the third element is starting after 50% of width of our container. So 25% width of first element and then 25% width of our second element. So 25 plus 25, that is 50%. And right after 50%, our third element is starting. So background position of our third child will be 50% of 500 pixel, that is 250 pixel. Okay, so we will use negative value and then 250 pixel. So look, we have also given the background position to our third element. Now similarly, we will give the background position to our last, or you can say the fourth element. So the fourth element is starting after 75%, 25% of first child, 25% of second child, and 25% of third child. So it will be starting after 75%. So 75% of 500 pixel will be 375 pixel. So I will write background position of our fourth child, and it will be 375 pixel. And now you can understand what I was talking about. I have given the background position to each of our span element in such a way that they are combinedly looking like a single image. Okay, so let me remove the borders from them so you can see clearly. And you can see it is looking like that this is only a single image, but we have used four different elements to create this single image. Now to create the folded effect, we have to give a kind of tilt effect to our span elements. And you can see the direction of tilt is same in first and third child, and the direction of tilt is reverse in second and fourth child. Okay, so we will first target the first and third child. So I will target the span element at odd places. Okay, so odd numbers are basically 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11 and so on. So this selector will target the span element at odd places. So we are basically targeting the first and third span child, and I will give them a tilt effect using skew y, and I will tilt them by 20 degrees. Okay, so now you can see we have given the tilted effect to our first and third child. Now I want to tilt the second and fourth child in opposite direction. So now I will target the span element at even places. So I will pass even here, and even numbers are basically 2, 4, 8, 10, 12 and so on. So this selector will target the span elements at even places. So we are targeting the second and fourth span child. So we have to tilt our second and fourth span elements in the opposite direction of this. Okay, so we will just pass a negative value, and now you can see we got a kind of folded effect. And now to make it more realistic, let's add box shadow to all of our span elements. So let me first remove the border from container, and let's add box shadow to our all the span elements. So I want the box shadow to be inside, so I will use the inset keyword. And for the x offset I want 20 pixel, for the y offset I want 0, and for the blur value I want 40 pixel. And for the color I will use RGBA format, and I will pass in the RGB value of black color, that is 0, 0 and 0. And for the alpha value I will pass 0.4, just to create a softer box shadow. So you can see we have completed our folded image effect, and it is looking amazing. Now if you want, you can stop the video here, or if you want to know that how to create more number of folds, you can continue watching this video. So if you want to create more number of folds, what you have to do is basically just increase the number of span. And now what you have to do is you will have to give 20%, because now we have 5 elements, and in order to give them equal space, you will have to give 20% to each of them. And now let's change the background position of each of them. So as I told you, you have to basically see from where the element is starting. So the second element is starting from 20%. So you can see the first element is getting 20% width. So the second element will start after 20%. So for the background position, you will have to use 20% of 500 pixel, that is 100 pixel. Okay. So you will have to write 100 pixel, And for the third child, you can see it is starting after 40%. So 20% of first child, 20% of second child, and therefore the third child is starting after 40%. So 40% of 500 pixel is 200 pixel. So you will write 200 pixel here. And now let's target the fourth child. And the fourth element is starting after 60%. So 20%, 20%, 20%, and therefore our fourth child is starting after 60%. So 60% of 500 pixel is basically 300 pixel. And now you can see the fifth span child is the last child. So now this last child pseudo class will select the fifth span child of our container element, and it is starting after 80%. So you can see 20% of first element, 20% of second element, 20% of third element, and 20% of fourth element. So our fifth element is starting after 80%. So 80% of 500 pixel is 400 pixel. So you have to give 400 pixel. In case if you are wondering why we are taking 500 pixel, so I had already told you that it is the width of our container. Okay, so I had told you the approach, and now you can see we have increased the number of folds and it is looking amazing. So this was it, guys. You can see how easily we created this awesome folded image effect using HTML and CSS. You just have to include the number of elements according to the number of folds you want. I wanted 5 number of folds, so I included 5 elements and then give them equal space. Okay, so give them equal space so that they combinedly fit the container, and give them the same background image, then change their background position as I had shown you, and you are done. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial and understood every single step, but still if you have any doubts related to any step, just feel free to comment your doubts below. Also, I regularly upload awesome tutorials like this, so make sure you are subscribed to this channel, and don't forget to check out about Newton School. The link to their website is in description, and I will see you guys in the next video.